The 25mm automatic cannon nestled inside the F-35A variant of the Joint Strike Fighter is now deemed to be an effective weapon. For years, a host of issues had left these stealth fighters unable to shoot straight. Problems with the 25mm cannon have also been a particularly notable talking point in the still controversial debate over plans to supplant the venerable A-10 Warthog ground attack jet with the F-35A Russ Goemaere. A spokesperson for the F-35 Joint Program Office, JPO, provided the war zone with an update on the F-35A's gun, which is formally designated the GAU-22A earlier this week. In the US military, the F-35A is operated exclusively by the US Air Force. After working with the Air Force and our industry partners, we can report that the gun has been improved and is effective, Goemaere said in a statement. We continue to work with industry, the services, and our international partners for further improvements and to maximize effectiveness and lethality at the tactical operational level. Each F-35A has a single GAU-22A, which is a four-barreled Gatling cannon with a rate of fire of 3,300 rounds per minute installed on an internal mount above the aircraft's left engine intake. To maintain the jet's stealthy characteristics, the gun's muzzle is hidden behind a flush-mounted door that opens when the weapon is fired and closes back up when it stops. The GAU-22A is a lighter weight derivative of the five-barreled GAU-12U found on the AV-8B Harrier jump jet and the now-retired AC-130 U-Spooky gunship. It is interesting to note that all other tactical jets currently in US military service, except for the A-10 and the aforementioned Harrier, are armed with versions of the 20mm M61 Vulcan cannon, a six-barreled Galting-type design. As installed on the F-35A, the GAU-22A feeds from a magazine with a maximum capacity of 180 rounds. Given the size of the magazine, the gun has just over 3 seconds worth of total available firing time during a single sortie. The short and vertical takeoff and landing capable F-35B and carrier-based F-35C variants of the Joint Strike Fighter, which the US Marine Corps and Navy operate, do not have internal guns. These versions can be armed with a GPU-9A gun pod, which contains a GAU-22A and 220 rounds of 25mm ammunition loaded on their centerline stations. The current standard operational round for the GAU-22A is the PGU-48B, a so-called frangible armor piercing, FAP, round with a tungsten core. This is a kinetic round designed to destroy targets through sheer force of impact. The frangible penetrator is designed to break up and turn into a hail of deadly shrapnel after penetration as well. German defense contractor Rheinmetall, which manufactures the PGU-48B, has touted the round as being particularly well suited to engaging enemy aircraft and armored vehicles on the ground in the past. The rounds are also expensive, costing around $131 each, according to the US Air Force's latest budget request for the 2025 fiscal year. At that unit price, it costs $23,580 to fully load an F-35A's magazine. For comparison, the Air Force's current standard 20mm PGU-28A/B semi-armor piercing high explosive incendiary cartridges each cost about $34. So, the price tag to fill up the 511-round magazine for the M61 Vulcan cannon on an F-16C Viper, the primary aircraft the F-35A is intended to supplant, is only around $17,000. There is always the possibility that other types of 25mm ammunition, such as high explosive and/or incendiary types, including ones already developed for use in the GAU-12U, could be cleared for use in the GAU-22A. What limitations there might be in making use of existing and future ammunition types beyond the PGU-48B are unclear. Though the internal guns were installed on production F-35As from the start, the first real ability to use them operationally came with the introduction of the Block 3F software package starting in the mid-2010s. testing in 2016 uncovered an initial set of issues impacting the F-35A with its internal gun and F-35B/Cs with potted ones. The problems were linked to how certain symbology was displayed to pilots through their helmet-mounted displays, HHMD. Unlike many combat jets, past and present, all three F-35 variants lack a traditional heads-up display, HUD, in the cockpit, and instead project the same kinds of information, and much more, directly onto the visor of the pilot's helmet. Even under optimal conditions, the F-35AJU-22A, with its 180 rounds, is in no way directly comparable firepower-wise to what is offered by the A-10C's legendarily massive 30mm JU-8A Avenger cannon and its 174-round magazine. But close air support is far more about precision-guided munitions employment than strafing these days. Still, it is an important tool to have available when the circumstances require it. It's worth pointing out that the Avenger also created a host of serious headaches during the development and initial fielding of the Warthog, as you can learn more about in this past war zone feature. The Air Force's position has long been that the ability of the F-35A, as well as other aircraft, to take over close air support duties from the A-10 lies more with an increasing focus on the use of precision-guided bombs and missiles. The A-10's advocates contend that the aircraft remains uniquely suited to performing close air support and other often overlooked missions, and that various steps could be readily taken to mitigate various operational limitations. You can read more about all of this in the context of the additional information from the redacted comparison testing report here. Questions certainly remain about the overall utility of the FF-35A's gun, with its just over 3 seconds of total firing time in an air-to-ground or air-to-air context. In an air-to-ground scenario, especially, the 25mm PGU-48B round presents its additional limitations in terms of what effects the gun can generate compared to ones that have the option of firing high explosive and/or incendiary ammunition, regardless of accuracy. Still, the 25mm rounds, even if limited in quantity, are far more destructive against air and ground targets than the more plentiful 20mm ones of a similar type found in all other American fighter aircraft. In air-to-air combat, Air Force F-35. A's are expected to use their stealthy design and other advanced capabilities to avoid having to engage in close-range dogfights where an internal gun could come into play. That being said, in a future conflict, especially a high-end one, there could be an unavoidable potential for these kinds of aerial engagements, even if they would still be uncommon. Altogether, after years of significant problems, the F-35A's gun now at least works to some relevant degree and gives pilots flying F-35 as the option to switch to guns against targets in the air or on the ground.